Have you wondered why birds move in a V-shape like this? So there are other birds at the edge and there are few in the front and on the other side. Then others can now be in between as they migrate or move to a given direction. Now, I did some little research and found out a number of things. I know there are a number of reasons, but I want to center on the ones that will help us learn something. Now, as birds flap their wings, they reduce the weight of the air that is inside. So, the birds that are weak, that is the sick ones, the old ones, and the young ones, are left to stay in between where the weight of the air has been reduced by flapping of wings of the ones that are the edge and front. So as the ones at the edge flapping their wings, they're reducing the weight of the air and helping the weak ones to also flap their wings so they can go at the same pace. The one in front is having a lot of weight because it's attacking the air head on and having the full weight of the air. And so what happens is that after some point, they can exchange. The one that was at the back now goes in front when the one in front is tired. And that is how they keep changing until they get to their destination. Now, the truth is that anyone who has risen in life was helped by someone, either directly or indirectly. Relationships are the lifts, are the escalators that push people up in life. You can never lift yourself with your own hand. It takes another hand to lift you. No matter how tall you are, you can never lift yourself with your own hand. The best you can do is to jump up. But you know what's happening? As you jump up, one thing that is guaranteed is that you are coming down. And so true lifting comes by someone holding you and lifting you. Anytime you see someone on top, someone flapped their wings and reduced the air for them so they are able to thrive and also move at that pace. But my question is this: who are you flapping their wings to reduce the air for them so that they can also move? Are you just living for yourself? Is there someone that as you are flapping your wings, their air around them is reducing and they're finding easy to move in life? That is the essence of life. That is the taste of life. If you don't have anyone that you are flapping your wings for, believe you me, you'll never taste fulfillment. Even in organizations where people work, there are people who only want to thrive by themselves. They want their success to be distinguished so that they don't want to tag anyone around them to partake of the same. If you only want to succeed alone, you'll carry the heaviest weight and you not like it. In order to succeed, please bring other people around you. Let other people also partake of the same. As they also flap their wings, they reduce the weight of the air around you and your rising and your moving forward will be easier. We are social beings and no one is an island. They say that one tree cannot make a forest. If you're struggling to make a forest with one tree, you are chasing wind. That is a mirage. Togetherness is what brings success. And that is why we keep suggesting that Africans, if you can come together, if Africans can unite to break the unnecessary boundaries, success is inevitable. As I conclude with a proverb, that is a united teeth that chew the meat. Thank you.